It's hard to find new stuff to not repeat what Bond's done before. This is the 19th Bond, so, and also to compete with the other great action films that are out there. So it's hard to think of fresh stuff, you know, but that's part of the challenge of this.
And in terms of even competing, I know when I see a film now, it seems like so many things are done with special effects.
Yeah.
And it's amazing, in fact, how much what we see on a screen is not real.
Yeah. Well, I think that's the big attraction of the Bond films, you know, because they're always the real thing. You know, that's why they take so long to do and such elaborate settings as you see now. And you, I think, don't get the feeling it's all being constructed by some wizard on a computer. There's a sort of reality about Bond action, which I think we're very anxious to kind of hang on to.
Have you been a Bond film buff over
the
years?
Well, yeah, I mean, I grew up with it, you know. I mean, my age, my generation, I mean, we grew up on all that, you know. None of us ever recovered from seeing Ursula Andress come out of the water, you know, so I'm part of that generation, so it's kind of weird to be part of it in this intimate way now.
As a fan and having grown up with it, does that sort of add a different kind of pressure to making?
No, there's enough pressure. I think there's enough pressure without any of that. The fact is that it's hugely successful. You know, you want to keep the success, you want to deliver what people want, and you want it to be that bit different, so it's fresh for the audience, and you feel that you can offer something and not just recycle, you know, an old Bond. So there's enough pressure, thanks a lot.
You will die along with everyone in the city.
Don't make this personal.
I can't do that.
James!
His only goal is chaos.
It appears that you have been beaten.
I thought it was your job to protect me.
I'm gonna find him.
Bond.
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 James Bond.